What is going on, everybody? Welcome to tonight's Chairleague match between Bad Rats World Championship Finals and Uncle eSports. So far, no one has showed up for Uncle eSports, so going to wait another 5 minutes here or so. I mean, they have until 6:50 Pacific to show up, otherwise they'll be disqualified. Not going to switch the camera right now because my cat is actually asleep in the chair I usually use to cast, and I don't want to bother her, so especially if a match isn't going to be happening here tonight. So going to wait a few more minutes here, about another 5 minutes, for Uncle eSports to show up. And if for some reason they haven't showed up, they will unfortunately be disqualified. So enjoy some more music in the meantime. All right, good news. Both teams are here, so the match will proceed. As scheduled as... I don't know. So this is going to be Bad Rats World Championship Finals versus Uncle eSports. The map will be Dragonshire. So I am going to go ahead and get that draft all set up right now. Let's see here. Gotta straighten this lobby out here, so just give me 1 second. Okay, I think we're all good now. So just going ahead and setting up the actually, let's see here. All right, so I'm just whispering out the captain's links now. We should be good to go. All right, so draft links have been given out, and we'll be good to go here. So yeah, my cat has been excavated from my chair. So usually I'm on a chair that's a lot lower, a little more comfy, but for casting, I like to have a nice high chair up. A chair that forces me to have a good posture. Something to sit up so I'm not all slouched in my nice relaxing chair. Alright, so the draft has begun. So Batterats has first pick. So this is Dragonshire. This is a map that highly values a strong solo laner in the top lane. And then a strong four-man rotation in the bottom. And Zul, one of the best heroes for that. So if Zul can rotate between the mid and bottom lanes, just clear the wave, move, clear the wave. He could put a tremendous amount of pressure on the structures in the mid and bottom lanes. And put his head dramatically ahead in XP, which you can use to very easily snowball to victory. And it will be Samuro banned out for Uncle eSports, which is not surprising to me. I think he's still at about a 65% win rate. He has been absolute hell so far in just quick match. I mean, he just always has an escape. Very difficult to kill. So I was listening to Town Hall Heroes a little bit today, and they're saying that he has a very weak early game. I guess it takes until level 16 before he gets, like, really, I guess, some really strong talents. They were saying, like, you just, against him, you could just basically, you know, pick, like, a heavy specialist comp and try to just win the game super early before he gets to that power spike. So, you know, you just kind of, like, four-man push a lane, take a fort, take a keep. But it's going to be Malfurion picked up for Batterats. Malfurion very good on this map. This is kind of like Brax. This is a map where sustain is very, very important. And Malfurion, one of the best supports at doing that. He got some nerfs in terms of his mana efficiency, but still very good in terms of sustain. Plus, he can give mana to his teammates and also lower their cooldowns, which is one of the nice new buffs he got recently. But it's going to be Thrall and ETC picked up for Uncle eSports. So Thrall, I think we're going to see in the top lane. And then we're going to see ETC probably be part of the four-man between the middle and the bottom. Probably see ETC go stage dive on this map. This is a large map. And thanks to the nerfs to ETC's Q, it's very difficult for him to land a really money mosh pit. So you're seeing a lot more people go with stage dive these days. And given how strong globals are on this map, it's very important to be able to rotate to shrines to get control of both of them and ultimately take the Dragon Knight. But Tyke is going to be picked up for Batterats. So, yeah, I mean, I think we're in part seeing that as a response to ETC. Which, I don't know, I mean, there's other heroes that are better for Tychus to go against. Such as Muradin, who actually is picked up by Batterats. So far, like, they have kind of an anti-tank in Tychus, who can kind of be a little bit bruisery. They have Muradin, who can kind of dive on an enemy backline. So Rek'Sai are banned out by Uncle eSports, but I'm wondering if Batterats, if they want to try to limit these support options for Uncle eSports into a Morales or something so that Muradin can dive on them. Might see a support banned out here. I would imagine Breitling would be banned out. Batterats, they already have a support. And they want to limit the support options for Uncle eSports. But it will be Kel'Thas. Interesting. You know, I'm not sure Kael'thas is all that much of a threat to Bad Rats. They do have Malfurion, who I think deals with Kael'thas very well, especially if he takes Tranquility. I mean, that's going to largely negate any of the effects of Living Bomb and Phoenix. Of course, Tranquility is on a gigantic cooldown, so there is that. So it's going to be Vala picked up as the sustained DPS for Uncle eSports. And they still need a support. I think Ariel would pair up very well with them. Ariel and Vala is a very strong combination. Vala can do very, very consistent damage, which is the kind of thing that Ariel needs. But no, it's actually going to be Uther picked up. Interesting. They may be looking to use that Divine Shield either on ETC for a Divine Mosh or possibly on Thrall to basically so he can go ham, get his health back, protect him from danger. It could also be to stop any potential dive from Muradin. Yeah, Muradin, a very, very heavy stun and CC kind of tank. Yeah, once Muradin gets on, so it's going to be very difficult to get away, thanks to Ironforge momentum and the slows he has from his Thunderclap and the stun from his Stormbolt. So Lunara going to be picked up for Bad Rats. And still think they probably need a Bruiser, so maybe Alarak? I'm predicting Alarak. Although Tychus might be enough of a kind of solid front line to pair up with Muradin. So, I mean, usually you want to have a support, a tank, a bruiser, and a range DPS. And the last role can be whatever. But Tychus is kind of the bruiser in this comp. Possibly. That's going to be Zagara, so actually, I like this pickup. I think that's excellent. So they're going to have someone who can go in the top lane with Thrall. And then Tychus will kind of take on the Bruiser role. I do believe he has the most health for a ranged assassin, if I'm not mistaken. So very, very tanky in terms of a ranged DPS. And he usually has to be fairly close anyway to the majority of his damage. So, last pick for Uncle eSports. Trying to think what they need in their comp. They basically kind of have everything covered. I feel like they could maybe go for a second support here. Maybe a Brightwing. Maybe a Tassadar. Uther, I think, has some real sustain problems. Like, he has very good burst healing, but in terms of his sustain healing, not that much. So, it is going to be Li Ming. So, awful lot of burst on the side of Uncle eSports. They have Li Ming, they have Thrall. They have ETC who can set up some absolutely nasty plays. Well, you know, I think I give the draft, though, to Bad Rats. They have Malfurion, they have a better sustained support. They have Zagara, who can definitely beat Thrall in the top lane. They have Muradin, who, if he takes a bunch of damage, he may usually just back off. Assuming he takes third wind, he can get back up to full health in pretty much no time. And then they have Tychus and Lunara, who can do very consistent damage. Doesn't take them a lot of mana to do that. Whereas I could see Uther running out of mana very easily. Same for Li Ming. But ETC, he can definitely take care of himself. does have very good healing. If somebody goes Prog Rock, you know, gathers all his gloves, he's going to be able to do fairly consistent healing for him and the rest of his team. The Bard ETC. Alright, but everyone is ready, so we are going to get this game started. So, for Batterats, it is Logicalia on Muradin, Rockaday on Lunara, Niam on Zagara, Kira on Tychus, and Stealth on Malfurion. And for Uncle Esports, it is going to be Hollis on Vala, Andolphus on Thrall, Gigglepants on Uther, The Stink on ETC, and CKG on Leeming. Gigglepants may have to battle Magic Pants to see who's the superior pants player. I forget what team Magic Pants is on. I think it's Kairos, I want to say. So, fully expecting a Thrall Zagara in the top lane with some kind of four-man rotation in the middle and bottom lanes. Both teams I expect to do a pretty much customary at this point five-man battle in the mid. I think I would give the slight advantage to Batterats in terms of their early game team fight ability. So far looking like a 5-on-5 clash here in the middle. Festive drop comes out. They're trying to scout out the bushes. Don't want to walk in there unless you know what you're dealing with. So we see an immediate rotation up to the top lane by Thrall. Which I think is very smart. If Thrall can beat Zagara into lane, he can deny her a little bit of her ability to set up. Zagara is very good in lane, but she definitely needs to set it up first. She needs to get her creep tumors down so that not only she has vision, she has the increased attack speed. Increased movement speed. So, power slide not going to connect on Kira, on Tychus. So, I think both teams are trying to do a four-man rotation, and it's going to be a little bit difficult with Malfurion. He did not elect for the Moonburn. Instead, well, with Shondo's Clarity, so he's going to be able to enable the rest of his team to not run out of mana, and enable them to clear the wave a little better, rather than do it himself. So, once again, Power Slide not going to connect on anyone, but Still people getting awfully low on the side of Batterats. So far, both teams fairly even in terms of XP with a very slight lead to Uncle Esports. So control of the bottom temple going to go over to Batterats, and it looks like as well as the top temple, so possible Dragonhead situation. Power Slide goes down to Muradin along with the Hammer of Justice, but Muradin absolutely not going to care. But Gigglepants on Uther in a lot of trouble. But luckily for Vala, Ghost Uther is better than Dead Uther, much better than Alive Uther in terms of being a healer. So, Batterats, secure that bottom temple, but Tychus nearly paid dearly for it. As the rest of his team, despite getting the kill on Uther, went off to do other things. So, bottom temple once again reclaimed for Uncle Esports. Thunderbolt goes down. Goes down on ETC. But not much in terms of follow-up. So, you know, honestly, I see this a lot. Both teams try to do a four-man rotation, but usually that four-man gets interrupted. Muradin, no longer being unstoppable on his Dwarf Toss, gets interrupted mid-jump by the Hammer of Justice. But it was usually, when you're trying to do a four-man rotation, usually that gets interrupted in some way. So a lot of people decide, just screw it. I'm just going to, stay in one of the lanes and not rotate. Make sure we don't miss that soak. And as Lunara, who doesn't have a mount, she does have a little bit more in terms of movement speed, but doesn't have a mount. It's just like you just stay in the middle lane and soak. So far, Zagara winning the top lane against Thrall. Yeah, she does have very good creep spread here, so... which is going to give her basically the ability to see most of what's going on up here in this top lane. Also, move much more quickly. Assuming she takes Nidus at level 10, she will have increased abilities on her creep. I believe she gets increased attack range. And also increased creep spread. So Thrall looks like he may be reclaiming top Trine, at least for the time being. Going to be forced off that by Zagara, who it looks like went in Venom Spines. Yeah. So it's going to give her a little bit more, I don't want to say burst, but a little bit more damage on her auto attacks. Usually you see Medusa Spines picked up, or Medusa Blades, I think it is. And I think the primary benefit of the Medusa Blades is that basically you're doing 3 autos for every 1 auto attack you try and do, which is going to reduce the cooldowns on your abilities thanks to basically battle momentum that's kind of baked into Nidus. So basically you're going to triple the amount your cooldowns are reduced from every auto attack you do. I can hear my cat doing things. So, Uncle eSports trying to reclaim this bottom shrine, but they're going to have to be very careful. They're getting awfully low. Tychus, though, getting chunked out. But Uther, low in terms of both health and mana, but he is going to be able to tap, but then again, so is Tychus. Of course, any Malfurion team always has tap available, because Malfurion does an excellent job of basically doing what a healing fountain does. Yeah, at least every 20 seconds he can give you healing and mana back. Well, 20 seconds with the Shando's Clarity. Obviously, he can heal much more often than that. So we see Lunara in the middle lane just soaking this, which is currently not being soaked by Uncle eSports, but they're not going to care about that too much because they're going to get the kill on Muradin, so... they may not be getting the XP from these minions here, but they're going to get the XP from killing that big bearded dwarf. We got Lunara rotating up to the top lane, trying to get a gank on Thrall. But not going to be able to do it. It's very difficult for Lunara to get a gank until she gets Leaping Strike at 10. Assuming she goes that route. But I would expect that. This is kind of a dueling map. A lot of one-on-one matchups. So it looks like Vala going to escape. Her hearthing not being sniffed up. So once again, we are at a stalemate on these temples. Big mosh pit though comes out, manages to catch two, and that is going to be the end of Tychus. So I really like seeing that proper focus there. They did not go for Muradin. Went for the slightly less squishy type Tychus. End up taking him down. So. Top Knight control by Uncle eSports bottom shrine, and I believe this is going to be... no, the Thornwood Vine comes out from Lunara, and actually I think that's a very good pick for her. Yeah, it's going to give her a tremendous amount of poke, which is going to prevent these Dragon Eggs from being taken, at least momentarily, and that is... there is nothing that is going to stop this. So the first Dragon Knight of the game goes to Uncle eSports, and has its sights set on this middle fort wall. And with only Tychus left to defend it at the moment, so far it's going to get very good value. It's going to get this entire wall, and probably this cannon tower as well. So far the Dragonite has not taken enough damage to force it to back off. You can see the timer on it is a little lower than its health bar, so which means at this rate time will expire before it's actually killed. But ETC getting awfully low. The Tranquility doing a great job of keeping everyone up. Great Divine Shield comes down on ETC, going to keep him up. The Sundering comes out. And Vala able to root, but unfortunately she vaults right into Roots, and she goes down. Devouring Maw comes down on Thrall, and I believe that's Uther, yeah. Thrall almost certainly going to go down, yeah. So, wow, so even though they had the Dragon Knight and got a few towers here, yeah, they lost a couple of their members, so. Not sure that was such a good trade. Looks like this siege camp going to be taken. ETC and Uther forced to back off. And everyone awfully low on the side of, well, at least Meriden is. His mana is very low. So going to be forced to hearth back. So even though he does have a Malfurion on the team, his ability to restore mana, it's only so much. He can actually restore quite a bit of mana if he goes for Versatile at level 4, which I think nowadays you almost have to take a Loon's Grace, but I was experimenting with that for a while. It seemed pretty good. But usually by the time you get to the late game, most people don't have mana issues anymore. Just because of the way things scale in this game. Power gathers within. So by the time the late game comes around, you pretty much always want that extended range. So kind of a little bit of a party boy situation, but it's going to be difficult to pick off ETC. He is fairly tanky. Meridian going to be forced to jump away. So, Shrine's coming up once again. Still have Zagara versus Thrall up in the top lane, who all this time has been pretty much a stalemate. Looks like Zag has a slight advantage. You know, we do see considerably more damage done to this tower, along with the ammo being drained. But Zag's starting to get a little bit low. And she actually did not go for Nidus, so she's kind of going to be locked into this lane and not going to have as much sustain as she would otherwise. She's also not going to be able to travel around the map globally to help contest the Shrine, so basically she needs to really win this top lane. And Thrall is making that very difficult for her. But also the fact that her team is dying bottom, also not helping her out. Tychus ends up going down. But Zag able to reclaim the top tower. Top shrine. So Thrall getting chunked out, but he does have plenty of mana, so he can basically just kind of spam his abilities and get his health back up very quickly. So the Thunder and the Big Sundering comes out from Thrall, but no, the Devouring Maw used to deny him from killing her. Killing Zag. So Thrall really going for the jugular there, but unable to secure the kill. He did bait out Devouring Maw, which is on 100 second cooldown, whereas Sundering, I believe, is only 60? No, it's 80. So, slightly in favor of Thrall there. Meanwhile, Zag forced to go back, which is going to give Thrall control of the top shrine, which means unless Meridian can get there in time, Vala, no, the Stormbolt just barely doesn't connect. Just a hair too late, and Vala able to secure the second Dragonite of the game for Uncle Esports. And this dragon thinking about finishing the job that it started and finally getting this middle fort. But getting awfully chunked out, thanks to Lunara and Tychus. Yeah, I mean, the Dragonite really needs all of his team here, and we see them all coming in to assist with this effort. If Lunara and Tychus can beat on the Dragonite freely, then it's going to go down very, very quickly. So the Dragon, it gets the middle four, it now has its sights set on the bottom. And I think they may be looking at a trying to posture to get the bottom keep, ultimately. Definitely not going to get it here, but The bottom keep is one of the more valuable keeps to take down. I think it's the most valuable keep to take down on this map. And the reason for that is the lane that you have three camps pushing. So it's very easy to set up a win condition for yourselves by taking down that keep, by getting the camps, really pressuring this lane hard. Oftentimes, if the middle and bottom keep are available and the Dragonette gets taken, you'll see the dragon just marked right for the bottom keep. Just ignore the middle one altogether. So, Uncle eSports thinking about an invasion of the siege camp, but that's going to get sniffed out thanks to Meridian doing his job, sitting in the bush, and using a great dwarf toss to get away. It's one of the things that makes Meridian so great. You know, he has such high health, he can absorb a lot of cooldowns from the enemy team. Dwarf toss over a structure, you know, a wall or something, so basically the enemy team can't get to him. And then thanks to the power of Third Wind, where is it? There it is! You basically get back up to full health in no time. Third Wind, very, very strong ability. So as I was talking about before, we see the giant camp and this bruiser camp pushing in this bottom lane. Trying to get the wall, but Uncle eSports going to back off. And it looks like they're going to pick up their bruiser camp. Looks like ETC and Thrall are going to take it. And they have plenty of time. It's another 15 seconds before these shrines are up, and this can be cleared much less than that. So it looks like for now, Uncle eSports going to secure the top shrine. I'm also going to do a lot to help this camp push by clearing the wave. It lets the camp basically get to the wall for free. So it looks like Bad Rat's choosing to basically just completely ignore that. They're saying, you know what, we probably can't get up there and stop you in time, so we'll just take your bottom fort while you take our top fort. Electing to just trade fort for fort, and I think this is a trade in favor of Bad Rat's. We were just talking about how important the bottom lane is on this map, whereas top, not as important. So if they're able to trade a bottom fort for a top fort, I think they'll take that all day. But they're forced to respond because they don't want to give up a keep, for sure. And they could have traded top keep for a bottom keep, but the bottom keep wall was much healthier for the side of Uncle eSports, and also there was a camp pushing for them. So they were definitely going to lose the top keep before bottom keep was even threatened. So both shrines now picked up for Uncle eSports. And Thrall doing a great job, realizing that he would be in danger if he got collapsed on by the entirety of Bad Rat. So he takes a very safe rotation up to the middle lane. Meanwhile, Lee Ming in a lot of trouble, but a great Divine Shield comes up from Uther, and Vala manages to sneak the dragon. I think Tychus put down the drill to basically stop the channeling of that, but I think maybe it wasn't in time, maybe it was attacking someone else. But Uther goes down, but not necessarily the first one you want to take down in the fight, because as mentioned before, regular Uther is kind of an okay healer. Ghost Uther, though, amazing healer. Ghost Uther, best healer in the game. So far, Meridian has been taken down by four Bad Rats, whereas Uther down on the side of Uncle eSports. So the dragon not getting too much done. It did get that keep wall. And without Uther, they're going to have to be very careful about this. Looks like this may have been sniffed out by that Wisp. It may have. But no, it's not going to matter. The keep will be picked up regardless. The camp will be picked up regardless by Uncle eSports. And once they've stolen the enemy siege, choose to come back and pick up the siege of their own, which will really create a lot of pressure in the bottom lane. Meanwhile, Uther is back up. Bibu Pants on Uther, rotating to be with the rest of his team. Who are looking like they want to take this bottom keep wall. So far, the first cannon tower has gone down. Big Devouring Maw, though, goes down on two. I believe that is ETC and Vala. Meanwhile, Thrall goes down. Vala in a lot of trouble. The heal comes out from Uther, but not going to be able to do that for a very long time. Vala goes down. Tranquility comes out to keep everyone nice and topped off as the chase goes on by Batarats. And maybe a bit of an overextension here on the side of Uncle Esports. I think they had level 20 at the start of that, but... Meanwhile, Uther is back up thanks to his level 20. And he is just going to go down for a second time. So, great job by Batarats recognizing that he had that talent. He was going to be up again. And unlike Ghost Leoric, Uther cannot hearth out of there. Cannot do anything. Basically just sitting duck. So, Shrine's about to come up. We will see the bottom one go in control of Batarats, along with this bottom Bruiser Camp. See, so this is a time where I would really like to see Nidus. So if Zagara had some creep and a worm up there, she could basically very easily use the worm to travel up there, secure the shrine, and get the Dragon Knight before everyone is up on the side of Uncle Esports. Of course, if you take Nidus, you don't have the big playmaking abilities of Devouring Maw, which we saw at that last fight, so there's definitely an argument to be made for both. So, top is taken by Batarats, but Thrall, once again, doing a great job of taking the bottom shrine and getting out of there. And it looks like this top keep, top fort, going to go down. Once you get into the late game, thanks to the scaling, I mean, basically, it's so easy to take down a fort just because your autos, all your abilities do so much damage. Meanwhile, the mosh pit comes out, not going to connect on anyone. And this is a 4-on-5. Okay, so Thrall has now showed up. Sundry comes down, hits Lunara and Murden. Fortunately, his team not going to be able to capitalize on that. Bolt comes out, so Thrall had to get out of there. Root comes down on ETC. The heavy impact from Thrall, Murden, able to finish him, but the death mosh, absolutely devastating. ETC Tychus forced to retreat. The Tranquility comes out. Unfortunately, that's not getting Tychus with that, but that's okay. Tranquility, honestly, not all that strong anyway. And as long as Malfurion can get a Q on Tychus, he's going to be just fine. Apparently, though, Tychus and him, not friends or something, I don't know. We're not seeing Tychus get any heals, but that's okay. He's going to go tap, I think. Yeah. So, bottom shrine now controlled by Batarats, and they're now looking to take their first Dragonite of the game. So, we could see Li Ming try and sneak this bottom shrine, but no, she's coming up to fight, which, oh, is a very risky thing considering this is 5-on-4 up here. So I'd really like to see someone pull back and get the dragon. Looks like Tychus will do that, maybe Lunara? I know, I'm really not sure why they're not pulling back. Okay, so finally Lunara pulling back, going to get the dragon, and the first Dragonite of the game goes to Batarats World Championship Finals. I'm finally going to say the full name of that team some point during this match. So, at 22 minutes in, this Dragonite is really going to be strong. But you can see just every chop of his giant Dragon Axe, I guess it's probably called, going to just absolutely chunk out those forts. So, and this is what I was talking about before. You know, a lot of times if you see the choice of the mid or bottom keep, you'll see the dragon go bottom, thanks to the immense pressure the camps put in the bottom lane. So we see these bottom keep walls just being absolutely chunked out by this dragon. And they don't have their sights set on this bottom keep. Dragon's still fairly healthy. So a big dwarf toss in by Murden. Avatar comes out, but Murdy getting absolutely chunked, and Malfurion unable to save him. David a little bit late on that Tranquility. Lunara in a lot of trouble. The Cleanse comes out from Malfurion, along with the Storm Shield. And the Roots come out. Great Roots from Malfurion. Going to keep Vala back. Unable to chase and attack a low Lunara. And Malfurion basically sacrificing himself for the rest of his team. What a noble act by this Malfurion. So he's basically going to let the other three get out unscathed. And by him going back towards the enemy side of the map, basically it means that it's a lot harder for Uncle Esports to really chase down and get into a position where they can threaten core, where they can threaten keeps. Just because they have additional map distance to travel. So Murdin going to be up here in about 3 seconds. Which means it's going to be a 4-on-5. So I really don't think Uncle Esports can end here. Especially with only one keep down. They have the camps pushing, but I don't think it's going to be enough. There's no healer on the side of Batterats, but considering that they're so close to the altar, it doesn't really matter too much. They just easily step back in there, get all healed up. So, a big dwarf toss in from Murdin. Avatar comes out, the healing static. Gigantic Maw! That is the entire team in there. The dwarf toss comes afterwards, stuns everyone. Divine Mosh, though, comes out. But ETC getting awfully low, but absolutely being chunked out by Lunara. But Ghost Uther doing a great job of keeping ETC up. And this time we see Redemption really pay off. So Uther went down. And thanks to the Redemption, comes right back up after getting everyone completely healed. When he comes up in Ghost Form, he has half health, but he has full mana. And he potentially has Benediction off cooldown, so he can really put out a lot of healing as the Ghost and the Resurrected Uther. But oh, wow, what a crazy end of that game. I really thought that Maw that hit everyone. Four-man Maw, absolutely crazy. Especially with the heavy impact from Murdin afterwards. I thought that was going to be a game. I thought that was going to be a four-man swing. I thought that was going to be a wipe for Batterats. And I thought they were going to turn that around there and win. But absolutely clutch play by Uther and Vala and ETC. The level 20 for Uther just getting immense value right there in that fight. Just absolutely tremendous. That was really a great, great, fantastic finish to that game. And congratulations to Uncle Esports for clutching that out. Great game. Let's see here. I will be casting another match here in, I think another like 2 hours or something, like kind of a long time from now. But first let me mark Uncle Esports down as the winner. Yeah, I don't know why Malph wasn't healing Tychus. I mean, poor Tychus. He had to walk all the way over to the well to get healed. I don't know. I mean, I don't think it mattered too much, but I mean, it was a little crazy. I mean, maybe they're not on friendly terms. Who knows? Maybe Malfurion just really didn't want to unmount, but it's kind of your job as the support to keep everyone topped off. You don't need to be first to a fight. So I will be casting BGN Company and Murgle at 8:40 p.m., so in about an hour. Casting one more for tonight, and hope you guys join me for that one. Hope it's just half as good as that match, because that was crazy. I'm glad that match happened after all. Waited around for a little bit at the beginning for everyone to show up, and thankfully they did, because that was a great match. So, all right, so that is going to do it for me for right now. Back in about an hour with another cheerleading match. So, thanks, guys.